me get back to you. Listen, don't let those Kiflom cocksuckers stop you from getting those sprinklers. They fight back, you take it to them. that shit on himself during the cook and freaked out too. It'll wear off soon. Great work today, Kiflom motherfuckers. Thank you. It's me. Later.
Into their ears, into their brain,
down their
system, the nervous system, into their chest, to help their heart beat, down to their bowels, right? To stir things up in their bowels. You understand? That's a cleansing. That's a damn cleansing. They sit on that toilet bowl, side saddle, and put one elbow on that flusher. You understand? Because everything's coming out. You know what? I'm getting Lionel back. Lionel was a damn good producer. Who's on the line? Please tell me it's Lionel. Lionel, you calling for your job back? Lionel!
Ray, I love the vibe, but it's mostly bullshit.
What the hell? We are raising awareness around here. Awareness, you dumbass fool! That's all it takes, and pretty soon, shit has changed. Because people don't realize they're being aware because you're getting awareness, and you don't know you got awareness until you get the damn awareness. Don't you tell me what I'm doing here. And we have done it all by holding a protest sign and wearing tie-dyes and smoking cheaper.
That's not actually doing anything, is it?
What are you talking about? The first three letters in raising awareness are R-A-Y. Raising awareness. Bumper stickers create change. People see that shit and think while they're driving. The text on that bumper sticker is speaking to me right now. At a red light, driving 55 down to 35, right? I'm going to visualize world peace. I'm going to go home and I don't care if my woman leaves me. I don't give a damn right now.
So what? I'm aware of global warming and pollution, but I don't give a crap. The news has made me an uncaring moron.
I tell you what I'm tired of. I'm going to tell you right now. I'm tired of all the so-called vegetarians and vegans in this state. I only eat raw meat. If you come back to my show and call me a fraud, I'll eat you raw. You understand? I'll cut you.
All right, let's get you sworn in. Raise your right hand. I do solemnly swear that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States as interpreted by my immediate superiors in the IAA. My duties may include interrogation, phone tapping, suppressing reports, inventing reports, paying bribes, taking bribes, the trafficking of drugs and arms, the misappropriation of funds, and lying to the American people whenever strategically necessary. So help me God. I'll take your silence as an enthusiastic consent. Congratulations.
Welcome to the IAA, Agent. Earpiece working? Good. Because your first assignment begins immediately. I've sent you some coordinates. Get moving and I'll brief you en route. Okay, let's start with the publicly available facts. The global price of oil per barrel is through the roof. Gas prices at the pump are off the charts. The agency has been granted unlimited resources to get the situation under control. What the public don't know is that behind the scenes, this is nothing more than a good old-fashioned criminal conspiracy to fix prices. And we have a leading suspect, the Duggan family. Diamond casino owners and big players in oil and gas. You're headed to the current residence of one Mason Duggan. He's the younger brother of Thornton, who runs a casino. Your assignment is to give my team access to his private files. We can see if there's a trail of breadcrumbs and where it leads.
Mm-hmm.
to give my team remote access to Duggan's personal computer. Now, if there's something there that links the Duggans to price fixing, they'll find it. Access to our standard issue hacking software on your phone. You're probably familiar with the program. We've been going third party with this stuff for years. Job. Oh, this data is a smoking gun, and the Duggan's fingerprints are all over it. It doesn't tell us how they're doing what they're doing, but get this. They're striking a deal to acquire something from those clowns at the Bureau. I can't tell what it is exactly, but we need to get our hands on it before the Duggans do.
Easy there, don't bump into me.
We have a couple of stops to make. The Duggans have been given two collection points by the Bureau. One is at their HQ, the other is at a seized contraband depot across town. You can choose what to hit first. I'll work up some options while you're en route. So, the Bureau HQ might look like it can't be infiltrated, but take it from me. As for the depot, it's essentially just an evidence room. It'll be a lot, but that shouldn't be a problem. If you're surprised the FIB are tangled up in this, you shouldn't be. There's almost no species of un-American activity the Bureau hasn't undertaken at some point. You ever hear of Steve Haynes? At tip of the iceberg. Okay, we've come up with an access point. And they have external contractors going in and out all day. Some kind of maintenance work. Now we send the location of one of their work sites to find some of their uniforms. I'm obligated to inform you that you have been given a standard issue GPS tracking device. Nothing personal. Just so we can follow your progress.
Thank you.
might sound stupid, but these people are highly dangerous. Tread carefully.
Thank you. Everything okay? I'll be here.
There's the boss. Oh, hi. How can I help you? Keep your blood sugar up. So long.
Dirty, rotten imbeciles. I don't need society.
Numbers up, you have to go. System says I told you so. Stocked in a plane like a truckload of cattle. Sent off to slaughter in a useless battle. Thousands of us sent off to die. Never really knowing why. Fuck the system, they can't have me. I don't need society. Let's go.
redemption and hot morons doing drugs in bikinis. Tragedy equals comedy if you give it enough time. Rehab Island. We've put Darwinism into the ultimate struggle as people battle addictions and each other in this hit competitive sobriety show. We take people to the limit,
push them over it,
and run commercials in between.
Alliances form.
Get out! Get out of this hut!
Loves are lost.
I thought you loved me!
I love the coke! I love cocaine!
Hearts explode.
And contestants flatline. Rehab Island. Reality finally gets real on CNT.
I don't want this station.
Channel X.
Sticks of love.
My friend, what's up? Free yourself. Breathe deep.
Yeah, that's bullshit what you said about coconut water.
Don't you go disrespecting coconut water. That's the nectar of the gods. From places that are mad spiritual. With cave paintings and baking sun and drunk circles and heat stroke and where you can swim with dolphins. Dolphins! And communicate with them. Swim with them and communicate with the dolphins. Dolphins are delivering babies, you punk ass.
I heard the dolphins molest people.
Where you hear that, woman? TV? That damn anti-spiritual booty box will suck the life out of you in a minute. Make your whole innards glaze over like someone threw your soul into an oven all covered in egg white.
What
this coconut water for right here?
Hey, partner.
I just drink some, and I'm a significantly more hydrated than you. I'm hydrated. I'm a whole lot wetter than you. People in
you got it, partner.
I'm never thirsty. They've discovered the miracle of coconut water. Crack. Crack. In the fridge glass. Now, each coconut maybe contains 6 ounces of coconut juice. Now, if you got a 16-ounce glass, you're going to want to bring two coconuts and hydrate yourself. Or you're chopped.
Man, this shit bomb.
Hey, it's me! Sure, I'll look into it. Well, here's something that's been on my to-do list for a while. Drop a fat chud on the Epsilon program. Let's tick that shit off. They have a bunch of farms where they grow plants for herbal remedies. That's code for mind-controlled juice, fresh meat. Seriously, do the research. Well, as luck would have it, Lab Rat's last batch of acid ended up being literal acid. Let's go pick it up and put it in their sprinkler system. Hey, if those robe-wearing weirdos try to stop you from poisoning the irrigation system, blow their heads off!
It's on now!
I gotta get cover!
You weakling!
You piece of shit!
You piece of shit!
Shit! Fucking Franco,
get behind some shit!
Thank you.
shit. Sorry if you got any of that shit on you. Lab Rat did, and I gotta say, that did not look fun. Anyway, kiflom, bitches.
What the hell? Monster! Who sent you?
This ain't fucking happening.
It just might be the day to quit a band you started. It happens all the time. Then you get to watch a chicken run around without a head. All the drugs, all the booze. Roll me out from under a car. It's time to play. Oh, wait. The audience. Sunday afternoon, we're all picnicking. They don't want to hear what we're playing. Go home. Watch the family special. Channel X.
Yeah.
ready to fill that void in your soul for a moment? Shop for the hottest new fashions at the casino store.
So I'm scrolling through Bleeder the other day, and I see some real funny comments from this cat that hosts that Fame or Shame show. What's his name? Lasshole. Talking about West Coast classics ain't what it used to be. Fuck off.
Looking good, boss.
Thank you.
Okay, now hear me out on this one. You know, rich people be having some of the crazy-ass pets, right? I mean, I'm about the only dude I know with a Vinewood address who only got a fucking dog. Well, my neighbor, this motherfucker in the music business, man, he owned a fucking monkey. And the little guy just got stolen by Meriwether. I swear, homie, I know it sound crazy, but if you anything like me...
All our operators are on call right now. Please try later.
Thank you.
All right, nice.
Everything okay?
What the fuck?